We won't show you this 15-year-old's face or tell you his name, but he wants his story to be heard.
I just hated having to go to school. I wanted to stay home as much as possible. It made me feel anxious.
It was 2016 and he was 11 years old when the alleged bullying started. A Year 7 student at one of Auckland's top schools, Sacred Heart College.
At one point I tried to walk to my class and I was stopped by a group of about 10 boys all blocking my way. And they, as I tried to push past them, they pushed me and pushed me to the ground.
Mum Siobhan kept a record of 90 incidents of bullying that year.
One of the bullies came up to him, surrounded by his friends, and said, go and commit suicide so I can piss on your grave.
Ms. Harvey's son was eventually diagnosed with severe anxiety and left the school, which has come under the microscope of the Chief Ombudsman. In a report, he says it's the third complaint about Sacred Heart that the office has dealt with in recent times, and that there seems to have been a failure to deal effectively with the behaviour that's taken a toll on the health of a student. He found the board's response to Ms. Harvey's complaint to be unreasonable and not well handled. Another former Sacred Heart student from 2016 says it's a familiar story.
I'd be pushed and shoved, I'd be taunted. Those sorts of experiences stick with you and create long-term consequences.
One News emailed Sacred Heart asking for comment today. We asked if it had a culture of bullying in 2016 and if it has one now. It responded with a statement prepared yesterday saying the board accepts the situation in 2016 was not well handled and that a raft of changes have been made. They also offered reassurance that new initiatives will be implemented to develop a stronger and caring college. For the Children's Commissioner, there's a broader issue at play.
We lead the world in terms of reported bullying in our schools, and that is a badge of utter disgrace.
A recent report found nearly a third of secondary students reported having been bullied at school. Andrew Beecroft wants validated anti-bullying programs to be compulsory.
There's got to be a climate where children can report without fear or shame, issues that they confront.
I would like change, but I'm very sceptical.
Scepticism after watching her son suffer in what should have been a safe place. Kimberly Downs, One News.